Adding this installation by Jenny Holzer to the campus is very significant in terms of Fran Ferguson's contributions as a steward of the historic campus at Vassar College.
There's really been no one in the last 100 years that has done more to beautify and improve the campus than Fran.
This is a natural extension of that dedication over 20 years and a suitable coda to a career that has put the appearance of the campus really foremost in people's minds as they visit Vassar.
First thing that we do is we take the big blocks and bring them in and put them under our block saw. We bring the blocks into this block saw. We can set up several blocks in here. The blade is 11.5 feet in diameter. We program the thickness of the cuts we need, and it takes maybe an hour and a half to make one cut.
I've always loved Jenny Holzer's work. When you see it in many, many different contexts, you realize that she deals with all of the aspects of life and love and politics that are part of everything that we also think about here at Vassar. And I love the benches, too, because the benches call you to look at each one in turn, to read what's on them, to have some understanding of the larger issues that she's dealing with.
Her aphorisms, her truisms that she's used symbolize a social activism that I think Vassar has always prided itself on, open-mindedness in terms of thinking that it's also prided itself on, so that this match of an artist who is politically very engaged, socially very engaged, and a campus that has produced many such people itself, I think was an ideal combination.
After the blocks are processed in the block saw, we bring the slabs in, we put them on this slab polisher, and it goes through a multi-step process to finish it into a home finish or a polished finish. The edges need to be finished just like the face, but they're done by hand with a hand polisher. In this case, the top is honed, so we're going to match the top with a honed edge. And you can see we put around on here, and it's all done by hand.
I have a number of long-term relationships with fabricators. I've been with the people in Vermont since the middle of the 80s, and I've worked with the same electronics company since the middle of the 80s. I like continuity.
1986 was the first time she came to us, so we did a project called Under the Rock. And that was my first experience with her, and I thought it would be the first and last, but that isn't how exactly it turned out.
You know, there are several aspects about the Holzer installation that seem very special to me. First of all, of course, we've used the poetry of Elizabeth Bishop, our very own graduate, as the words on the benches. So we connect in a very direct way with Elizabeth Bishop's poems as we walk along and read the different benches. More than that, I've always tried to suggest to students that they take the time to sit, to relax, to contemplate, and not just simply to be involved in one activity after another during every day. So I think that both through the activism of the words that she uses and also the suggestion that one should sit and think for a while, it's a very, very appropriate statement for the Vassar campus. Moreover, of course, these benches are extraordinarily high in their quality, just absolutely gorgeous to look at. They fit into the landscape magnificently.
I thought to bring the art center and art more to the student body as a constituency, because the Friends had historically been spending much of their time on activities associated or directed towards alumni. And I thought, what better way to bring the students to our great art collection and art center than by bringing the art to them and putting it on campus in a heavily trafficked area where students would see it every day.
I've used benches in a few other installations, but what's specific about this one is that it's Bishop, and she's from here, and it seemed to make a logical and a coherent piece. I went to Bishop because she's good, and she's accessible, and she has such a wide range. She goes from love poems to ones about desperate situations in the world.
When Jenny Holzer sends us a project, I will get the information and I will put it into my computer, and then I will DPF it, which is sending the drawing that's in my computer right to my cutter. It's on the rubber stencil, so the sandblasting doesn't ruin any other part of the stone except for where the letters are pulled out.
Not to think of benches as funereal, I think of them as good places to sit. I can imagine, and I hope to see, any number of people sitting on them awake or asleep. I wanted to find a place on campus where people are all the time, and so we chose this one that's on the way to the dining hall, and I thought that would be surefire.
I think they'll age well. I think the messages are timely and universal ones, no matter what century or what decade you're part of. And Jenny Holzer's choices, her excerpts from Bishop's poems, are really those that speak to many different conditions of the body and soul. And so those things tend not to go out of style.
Great art and great poetry, what more can you have to stand the test of time? Thank you.